graders, we are going to make bears with ugly sweaters. Well, I don't know how ugly the sweater is, but it's definitely kind of crazy and loud and full of pattern. So I want to talk to you today about different patterns and different kinds of designs. In the video that you just watched before this, it showed you radial design. Radial design starts with a center point, and then the lines or the shapes or the design come out of it in a circular pattern. And you can see there's more than one radial pattern on here. There's one around the eyes. There's one happening around his face. And then we also see part of them on the ears. And then of course down here we have just a regular pattern. If we were looking at him, excuse me, from a bird's eye view, you might see a full circle, but we're just seeing the front of him for this particular one. So what you'll need is a paper, a pencil, and if you have a Sharpie or a black marker, that would be great. And then we will get started. Oh, also, if you don't want to draw your head circle freehanded, you might go find yourself a nice piece of Tupperware out of the kitchen or something that has a nice big circle so that you can trace that. Because if you're not comfortable making a circle, then find something that will help you. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is make the bear's head. And so I want to have a fairly big circle. I want it to leave room up on top here for an ear here and an ear there. And it should go almost to the edge of the page, but not quite to the edges. And then you wanna leave some room down here for that sweater that we're gonna put on him. So I'm gonna trace around this. Okay, so I've got, and the Tupperware dish, I just noticed it wasn't a perfect circle, as you can see, but it will do. And then I'm going to put some half circles up here for ears. And you don't want to, I'm drawing it dark because I want you to be able to see the lines, but you don't want to draw these details too dark because they're not going to be part of the design. They're just going to be a guide when we start adding our hair. Then I'm going to create a simple line coming down there and there, and that's where our bear's sweater will come in, okay? So what we first need to do is his little nose and his mouth will go right here. It's a simple upside down triangle, kind of like so, and then straight line down, and we'll make a fish hook to the left and a fish hook to the right. All right. Now, very lightly, you'll notice this is kind of a pear shape. I'm going to create a pear around that area. Okay, because what that's gonna do is help us with this fur area. So we know where to start. So I went round up here and I got a little wider down along the bottom, sort of a pear shape. Then you're going to, on either side, put your two eyes, one over here and one over there. And there you have the outline of your bear. We're going to do some stripes. And I'm gonna leave them wide enough that I can put some kind of a pattern inside each of the stripes. Because after all, if I just leave this plain stripes, that's not truly a very crazy looking sweater. So what you're gonna do now is think radial designs. Radial designs are designs that start with a center point and then they come out of it in a circular form. So your hair that's on your bear is going to start very close to the eye and go all the way around. And then you're just gonna continue doing that in a circular design. Keep going out from the eye until it runs into his nose. Okay, so I am just about there, and there is our first radial design. The next radial design will come out of the other eye. And again, because we're doing a bear, we're using lines to represent his fur. So I'm going to go around, and then another layer outside of that. And then I just keep doing that until I get to his nose, just like I did on the other side. And there we go. Okay, so now I have to incorporate the center and the other parts of my bear. So now a traditional radial design is a circle. This is not quite a circle. We kind of made a pear, but you're going to make the hairs come out from the edge of this shape that you've made. Okay, and so these guys are gonna come out until the hairs run into the bottom of your bear's chin. Okay. So now what we have here is a pattern that's coming out of his mouth and nose area, and patterns that are coming out of his eyes. We also are going to give his ears a radial design. I'm going to put centers in there, again, lightly, and then the hairs are going to come out of that half circle shape and continue to radiate out till you touch the other side. Probably only about two, maybe three rows of lines is all it'll take to get that. And then once you get to the other side, you stop. Okay, so I've started my designs, my radial designs. I have a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them. Now I need to fill in the rest of the fur. Does it matter which direction? It does, actually. So we're gonna make this part go up. Okay, kind of like that. Now we're going to make the hairs come out around this design. So it's going to go outward like so. And then all of our designs kind of meld or go together. And you keep doing that until your bear is done, until you've reached the edge of your bear. And each time I go around, I get closer and closer to the edge. And when I get all the way to that edge, I stop. Same thing up here. And same thing over here. Now, as soon as I have finished putting his hair on there, then I can start thinking about, well, what kind of crazy designs? And I, because I usually think of ugly sweaters as those crazy Christmas sweaters, I usually pick kind of Christmassy designs, but you can really use whatever patterns you want. I know in our house, my sister was famous for having the craziest, most creative sweaters. Some of them were pretty crazy. So it could be as simple as, you know, a nice zigzag triangle pattern like that. Maybe the next one will be curvy, going in the other direction. But you want to have, like I said, several lines or shapes for each pattern. Otherwise, your sweater's not very crazy. And maybe this one will have, we'll go back to the radial design and make circular patterns coming out of it. And then when I color that in, I can definitely make that crazy and loud. Loud with color, that is. And maybe down here we'll just have a couple stripes. So the next thing you're going to do after this is simply get your Sharpie out. And when you go over the lines, do not go over the outlined areas around your bear's head. We just want to have the hairs on the edge. We don't want to see the line that you put there. That was only a guide. So I'm going to start with the eyes, and I'm going to put a little banana shape in there so that it looks like he's got a little shine in there. So another little banana shape. I'm going to color in his nose, and I'm going to leave a little highlight right there on his nose to give him a little shine. And I'm going to outline his mouth. And again, after this, no more lines. Do not put the line around here. Do not put a line on around there or around his ears. Strictly going over the hair. And guess what? If you accidentally don't go over the exact line or hairline, that's fine. But what'll happen now is you don't need an outline showing where the edge of that shape is because your hairs are going to help with that. So there we have our textured bear made with a radial design. Now, the next thing you can do is to get rid of some of those lines that we don't need anymore. I can get an eraser. And what happens is if I erase those outlines, there is just a nice little texture where the edge of your bear is. And you don't have to worry about those lines being there because your design, because you created it in a radial pattern like that, creates a nice edge for you. So that is as far as we're going to take that for today. So put your name on the back of him or her, save them, and when we go remote next time, I will show you the next step and how we're going to color in our bear with his ugly sweater.